in this age of consumerism, if I have to identify one commodity which is consumed the most, not only that, one commodity which is actually manufactured by the consumer, and the one who consumes it is also consumed by the commodity. I'm talking about worry. Worry is a commodity which is consumed the most, especially these days. It is manufactured from scratch by the one who consumes it, and worry also consumes you. Human beings have been worrying ever since times immemorial. The worries have been changing. Initially, the worries must have been how to find food, or maybe fear of some wild animals. Then, as civilizations started progressing, worries changed. Today we have the big worry of corona, and we also have other worries which are sort of promoted by social media and other technologies which we have developed. Now we have the worry about why we are not getting so many likes for our posts. Well, worry is a horrible habit to have. Worry is a habit which is responsible for a lot of people getting anxious. It's responsible for a lot of angst, depressions. Well, I have a lot of bad habits, but one bad habit I do not have is worrying. I never worry. I refuse to engage with worrying. There's a word for those who don't drink alcohol. They're called teetotalers. In that sense, I'm a worry totaler. Sometimes worries come, very attractive ones, very good looking ones, and try to seduce me. But I refuse to allow them to come anywhere near me. And that's perhaps the reason for the perpetual smile which I have on my face. A few days ago, I interviewed the chief doctor who started the Corona Hospital in Goa. The objective of the interview for the television was to sort of get rid of people's fear about Corona and educate them about Corona. Well, after my interview, the next day, the news came that the doctor whom I had interviewed for about an hour was corona positive, and I was exposed to this corona positive person. So I had to quarantine myself. So I quarantined myself for about 7 days, all by myself. I moved the bed into my studio at the Museum of Goa, and I closed myself in the studio, and I started reading, I started drawing, I made a few paintings, I started listening to some wonderful podcasts. And I also wrote many essays, and one of the essays is this one about not worrying. I was, of course, symptomless, and I was not worried at all. I went to the hospital, got the corona test done, and I waited for the results without thinking about the test. And I must tell you that I enjoyed those 7 days of self-quarantine all by myself. Now, I had a colleague who also went through similar situations. Now, his response to that quarantine was completely different from mine. He started worrying, he started imagining that, okay, the test will come positive and he will suffer from corona and he will perhaps die. He was completely depressed, he could not sleep, he could not eat his food. That's what he confided in me. He must have attended his own funeral quite a few times during these 7 days. Now, his response to the quarantine was completely different. He was worrying himself to death. The test results came. I was negative. He was also negative. But the response to the quarantine was completely different in these two cases. I started thinking that since I have a very positive approach and I don't worry, I must share my experience with my audience so that they also, perhaps some of them, might stop worrying. So I started collecting a lot of material connected with worrying. There are many, many interesting thoughts, many interesting quotations by wise people connected with worrying. Bernard Shaw says that we are attached to the worries more than the worry is attached to us. You know, birds of worrying start flying over you. You cannot stop that. You cannot avoid that. A lot of worries will come your way. The birds of worries will fly. But then it is up to you not to allow those birds to make a nest in your head. Worrying is like a little stream of fear which start trickling down in your head. You have to stop it at the right time. If you don't stop it, this little stream of fear becomes bigger and becomes a torrential river. And then this river will consume all your sanity, all your rational, all your joys and happiness, and you will be reduced to a wreck. So most important is the moment this trickle starts of worry, you have to put a kind of a bond to it. You have to dam it. So there is a Swedish proverb which says, worry is something which gives a small thing a very long, big, giant shadow. Actually, the things are very small. You know, research has proved, the studies have proved that 90% or more of what you worry about never happens. There was a man who was on a deathbed, old man, and he confided with his doctor. He said, "Doctor, all my life I've been worrying, but all the things I worried about actually never happened." And the poor fellow was consumed by the worries to his death. Worry is described as a rocking chair. It gives you something to do, but then it takes you nowhere at all. You know, worrying makes you sleepless. Sometimes you are just not sleeping, you have insomnia. If you are not getting sleep because of worrying, best thing to do is just to get up and start doing something fruitful. Because just worrying is not going to help you at all. And ultimately, it is the worry which will get you, not the lack of sleep. Worrying actually does not reduce the sorrows of tomorrow. Whatever sorrows are supposed to be coming will come. So the worries does not rob tomorrow of its sorrows. What it does actually is robs today of the joys. It is very important to enjoy now, the present, and not worry about tomorrow. You know, the best one I like about worry, the quotation, is worrying is a misuse of imagination. If you have imagination, please use it for some fruitful purpose, for some good purpose, to imagine some nice things. Don't use it for just brooding over something and worrying. So worry is an absolute misuse of imagination. I thought I will draw a few cartoons just to propagate, to make my points, because humor is a very good vehicle to take ideas across. Especially in this corona times, worrying in the world has increased exponentially. Everybody is worried. Everybody thought before the corona times that morbidity, death, is a faraway thing. Everybody was living under the illusion that we can control our disabilities, disease and death. That's what people thought. It was an illusion. What corona has done is to demolish this illusion. Corona has taught us that, well, death, morbidity is not in your hands. So all that we need to do is whatever we can do to prevent an attack of corona, infection of corona, we should do. We should maintain social distancing, wash hands as much as possible, wear a mask in public spaces, avoid gatherings. But beyond that, nothing is in our hand. It was only an illusion that we had control over our destiny. We did not have, and we continue not to have. So please do not spoil your present worrying about what will be happening next. Enjoy this moment. Life is very precious, and we cannot waste it worrying.